Kick for Life FC is the world's first soccer club exclusively dedicated to social change. As a multi-award-winning nonprofit and social enterprise, our mission is to change the lives and long-term prospects of vulnerable young people in Lesotho, Southern Africa. Kick for Life works with a wide range of partners, including the U.S. government, UNICEF, and FIFA, and we have gained support from global icons such as Prince Harry and David Beckham. We are based at the Kick for Life Center in the heart of Maseru, Lesotho's capital city. Our flagship program is the Kick for Life Academy, where participants are offered high school education scholarships, soccer training, nutritional support, tutoring, and a tailored character development program. The ultimate objective of the project is to develop disadvantaged boys and girls from Lesotho into high-performance students capable of obtaining scholarships at schools and colleges in the USA, genuinely transforming their lives in the process. Kick for Life has also reached over 200,000 young people with a range of wider community initiatives, including an interactive curriculum focused on good health and well-being, and Girls United, which uses soccer to promote women's empowerment and gender equality, and to tackle gender-based violence. We have also developed a range of social enterprises, including a restaurant, hotel, and conference center, with 100% of the profits from these businesses pumped back into our charitable activities. The restaurant, number 7, and the hotel are ranked number 1 in Lesotho on TripAdvisor. Our senior men's team play in the Lesotho Premier League, and our senior women's team play in the Lesotho Super League. In 2020, Kick for Life became the first top fight soccer club in the world to commit to equal gender budgets. Kick for Life is now a recognized market leader in the nonprofit and social enterprise sectors. We have been on an incredible journey, from a small charity to a multi-award-winning organization and a Premier League football club, with Lesotho's top restaurant and a hotel and conference center. A range of external evaluations have consistently shown that our social development outcomes are outstanding. Our work is recognized globally, and our model as a new type of football club seeking to leverage success on the pitch for groundbreaking social change has attracted a huge amount of local and international interest. We are proud that we are making actual, tangible, positive change in the lives of disadvantaged youth. Tonight, your support will enable more young people from Lesotho to obtain student-athlete scholarships in the United States, providing them the opportunity to reach their potential and to permanently transform their lives. Thank you for joining the first ever Kick for Life virtual gala.
Hello everyone, this is Juan, and I wanted to leave a quick message to support our friends at Kick for Life. As you know, we collaborate with them through our movement Common Goal, and we are very much aware of how great organization they are, how innovative they are, especially in the field of social enterprise, which is an incredible idea, so I encourage you to support them. I thank you for your time, and hopefully I can meet you all very soon. Thank you.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to the Kick for Life Virtual Gala 2020. I'm absolutely delighted to be joining you here live from the beautiful city of Cape Town in South Africa. We have a fantastic evening lined up for you, and over the next hour, you'll be hearing some incredible stories from Kick for Life participants in Lesotho. We have a silent and an impact auction, and we have a very special guest interview with Italian soccer star and longtime Kick for Life ambassador, Giuseppe Rossi. I'm now going to hand over to Motlatsi, who's in the stunning Mountain Kingdom, and he's going to tell us a little bit more about why tonight is so important.
Good evening, everyone. It is 2:30 in the morning here in Lesotho, and I'm thrilled to join you from the Kick for Life Center in Maseru. 2020 has been a challenging year, and COVID-19 has presented a unique set of challenges for our work. We have had to adapt, improvise, and find new ways to fulfill our work. And now more than ever, the pandemic has highlighted the urgent need for life-changing interventions to help the most vulnerable children in our world. Soccer has a big part to play, and in June, we made a groundbreaking announcement about our soccer teams. Here is our country director, Hannah Taiji, who is currently in Vancouver, Canada, to tell you more.
Thank you, Matlatsi, and hello, everyone. Lesotho remains a largely patriarchal society, and gender inequality exists in many areas of life, in the workplace, at home, and in sport. Soccer is a very powerful tool for challenging social norms and empowering women. In June, we announced that Kick for Life FC would become the first top-flight club in the world to have gender-equal budgets and pay. The announcement attracted global media interest, and it has also given us an incredible platform to offer life-changing opportunities to many more deserving girls and boys. And now, over to Kick for Life's U.S. Board Chair, Peter Malloy in Los Angeles. He'll explain how you can help us bring this vision to life.
Greetings from Los Angeles. Through our World Class Academy program, we provide young people with a quality academic education, a tailored nutritional program, healthcare, psychosocial support, safe accommodation, soccer coaching, and character development. The result is to genuinely and permanently transform their lives, ultimately supporting them to obtain a college degree here in the USA. And so every donation tonight, every successful bid will go directly towards helping more young people on this journey. And every $10,000 raise will mean one more girl or boy can be supported for the whole of 2021. Wishing you all a great night, and thank you to all of you for helping to change the lives of these children.
Wow. Hi, everyone. Welcome. Thank you so much, Kick for Life, for those opening remarks. And thank you, Juan Mata, for that amazing welcome message that we heard a few minutes ago. That opening segment has gotten me so excited for the rest of the show. I hope you guys are as excited as well. I want to give a special shout out to DJ Hanza and MC Karoo for playing that awesome music that you heard when we were getting started a few moments ago. You'll be hearing that again late into tonight if you were in New York for the gala last year. DJ Hanza was keeping the party going very late into the night, and he will be keeping the party going tonight as well. I saw in the chat already some of you guys giving shout outs to him. So he's obviously very popular. I'd like to just say I'm so thrilled and just so excited to welcome you to the first ever virtual Kick for Life Gala. 2020 has brought on unprecedented change and just things that we're not used to seeing. And we've had to adapt, so we're adapting. And this is the virtual gala, it's the first time we're doing it, but we're excited. Tonight's gonna be great. We have a goal in mind, and I have a feeling that we're gonna reach that goal. Thank you so much for joining us for Kick for Life's biggest fundraiser of the year as we bring together our community of supporters from across the United States and all over the world. As you just saw, messages of support from all over the world, literally. We thank you for your dedication and for spending your evening with us tonight. You are a huge part of why Kick for Life is where it is today, and you're a huge reason why Kick for Life is successful. So you're probably wondering who I am. I'm Michelle Gingras. I am a sports reporter in New York City, and that is where I'm joining you from, my living room in New York, because we are just in completely unprecedented times. But it is an absolute honor for me to be here with you guys tonight. I am so happy to be spending my evening with so many people who believe in Kick for Life and have seen the impact firsthand and want to see more change for the better in the world. So with that being said, 2020, as I mentioned, incredibly challenging year. However, the work for Kick for Life is more important than ever, which is why we are so delighted that you have been able to join us for Kick for Life's first virtual gala tonight. Thank you for joining us this evening. We hope that you have a great time. We have a lot of fun things planned for this night. When we were leading up to it, how we were going to do this virtual gala, I'm just so impressed. All of the people behind the scenes who have made tonight so incredibly exciting for you guys. I think you'll be really impressed as well as we progress through the night. As many of you know, and then many of you who don't know, Kick for Life is obviously a charity and social enterprise. It uses the power of soccer to transform the lives of vulnerable people in Lesotho, South Africa, through a wide range of social development activities focused on health, education, and support through sustainable and towards sustainable livelihoods. I know we have a lot of guests here tonight that may be joining just for the first time, and we have other people who have been supporters for over the years for us. So we are so excited to have both of you here, and we're so thankful and appreciative that you're deciding to spend your night with us tonight. Among many of the social development accomplishments Just recently, Kick for Life was named the world's first top flight soccer club to commit to equal budgets for women and men's football teams. They are leading the way in the sports industry as a whole, and that is just absolutely incredible. Equal budgets for both men and women in football. That is unprecedented, and it's amazing to see them leading the way like that. So, a little bit more about this event tonight, guys. All of the proceeds will directly support the Kick for Life Academy program that provides world-class, long-term, holistic support to young people in Lesotho. Your donations tonight will go directly towards high school scholarships, soccer training, character development, and just so much more. That's only a few of the things, and I'll go into more detail about really where your money breaks down and where it goes. This is so different tonight. I understand that. This virtual gala, I'm going to try to hype you guys up. I hope you're as excited as I am. The goal remains the same. The objective here is to raise as much money as we can to support the boys and girls to obtain scholarships and to go to schools and colleges in the United States. As you can imagine, this genuinely transforms their lives. It removes these kids from the cycle of poverty and gives them an opportunity to achieve their potential and then to give back to their own communities later on as well. The opportunities that they receive, the doors that are open for them because of you. In turn, when they go back to their own communities, they're able to share those experiences, to be role models for the next generation, for those young kids that then get to be in their shoes later. That's all because of you. I cannot emphasize enough that without the support of the community in the United States, the support of you, where all of you are sitting right now at home, wherever you are, none of this would be possible at all. So please give yourselves, first of all, a pat on the back, but don't be satisfied because we have a lot of work to do still, and we're gonna hopefully get some of that work done tonight, okay? So as I mentioned, everyone, 100% of your donations for the event will go directly towards this high impact project. I'm gonna put some of these numbers in context for you because sometimes these numbers can seem daunting. We're asking for a lot of money and we need that money. And I think maybe if I break down where that money is going, it might be easier for you guys to understand that and to see that impact firsthand. So every $10,000 raised enables us to put another young person in Lesotho through the program for an entire year. That supports them on their journey to graduate in the United States. As you can see on your screen now, we have a big target tonight, okay? We're gonna try to reach $70,000 tonight. Right now, we're just above 24,000. Actually, we're almost at 25,000, which is incredible. That's a great way to start. I have high hopes that we can reach $70,000 tonight. I think we could reach even more than that. We just gotta get excited. Everyone here has to donate. Everyone here has to be part of this change, this social change for better. Some of you guys already got the ball rolling. As you can see on the screen, we've received some very, very generous donations already throughout the night. And I'll make sure to reiterate this, as I said, throughout the night as well, but you can make donations texting the word give and the amount that you'd like to give to 76278. As you can see, a $50 anonymous donation coming in right now, $2,500. Thank you so much, John. Thank you for that generous donation. That's incredible. Another $25. It's amazing. Guys, even, you know what? Any amount that you can give makes a difference tonight. You can instantly make a difference by donating. Don't overthink it. Look, I know this has been a hard year. I know it's not easy for everyone to give $2,700. Thank you so much for that donation. $3,000. Anthony, thank you so, so very much for that donation. Guys, let's keep this coming. This is so incredible. Courtney, thank you so much for your contributions. Any amount makes a difference. I know it's a hard year, guys. I understand that. But this is an opportunity to create some good out of this year, to really make a difference in the lives of kids in Lesotho. You are making a direct impact on their lives. So for those of you who have just arrived, welcome. This is different. As I mentioned, it's going to take a few minutes for people to get used to how to work all of these chat functions and to kind of just adapt to seeing me virtually on your screen for the next hour. So while people get familiarized and get online, I am going to go through some logistics and some housekeeping to make sure that this event is as interactive as possible for you guys. So as I mentioned, we have a very, very special lineup planned for you all this evening. Honestly, one of the things that I'm most excited for, you're gonna hear from the head of women's football and Kick for Life and social change pioneer. Her name is Pookie. She is incredible. You'll also hear from a Kick for Life student athlete, Sanate, and the Kick for Life Youngest Women's Player and Academy Scholar, Maura Kane. These three women are so inspiring, and to hear their story, I think, is going to make you feel just hopefully extremely motivated to give to more students like them so that other people can have the same opportunity that they've had through this program. We're also going to have the pleasure of hearing from a professional Italian footballer. You may have heard of him, Giuseppe Rossi. He now plays for Real Salt Lake. We're going to also take a look at some insights from Lesotho, as well as feature an amazing, and I cannot emphasize this enough, amazing silent and impact auction. We're also going to give away some prizes at the end, and there's lots more as well, guys. We are gearing up for what is going to be a fantastic night. I'm looking in the chat right now and just seeing all of your feedback already. So we're so excited. Thank you for being here. Thanks for engaging in this chat function. I'm actually going to get to that right now so that you can understand how to do that. On your screen, you should see the chat function. So this allows you to chat openly with all of the attendees. We're going to use this chat option throughout the night to just continue to just raise each other up and to continue to just, you know, this is different. We're all at home. How can we keep the energy high? How can we encourage each other to donate? How can we, you know, maybe inspire someone else to give money tonight? That chat function is for you guys. I hope that you call each other out on it. I hope that you guys match each other's donations. That is really for you to take advantage of. So make sure that you choose all panelists and attendees in the chat box when you send any messages, and you can use that chat function throughout the night. So that being said, I'm gonna test you guys now. I would love to see who's here. And I would love to know if it's where you guys are joining from. So go into the chat and let's see where you are. What city, what state, what country, where are you guys watching from? And where are we all seeing this together tonight? Let's see. Hoboken, New Jersey. You're not very far from me. Seattle, Washington. Very nice. New York. Oh my goodness. They're coming in so fast now, guys. This is great. Denver, Colorado. Very good. Providence, Rhode Island. Princeton, New Jersey. The UK, Westport, Connecticut, San Francisco, Philadelphia, Staten Island, New Haven, Connecticut. You're honestly going faster than I can even keep track of. This is incredible. Weston, Connecticut. A lot of people rep in New York City. That's right. Oakland, California. Very good. Freehold, New Jersey. We have people literally all over the world. More people from the UK. Awesome. Greenbrook, New Jersey. I love it. I love to see it. Thank you guys so much. I'm feeling your energy right now, and I am so excited for this night. I think it's gonna be a really, really good one. So as I recently mentioned, we have a silent auction that is currently live to help raise funds for Kick for Life tonight. If you've already registered in GiveSmart with your cell phone number, you'll be receiving a text right now to access the items and to start bidding. All you have to do is click the link in the text or in the chat. And if you're not registered to GiveSmart, no problem at all. You just need to text K for L Virtual Gala to 76278. From there, you'll be prompted to enter your name. And from there, you'll be guided to the auction site. So very easy steps. I'll go through that again. Text K for L Virtual Gala to 76278. Oh, I see a Southampton. Very nice. More New Jersey, Los Angeles, California. Thank you guys so much for tuning in and letting us know where you're from. Jean Fleming, another Southampton. Love it. Very good. Okay, so be sure to click the two check marks when you get to GiveSmart, and that is how you do it. From there, we're going to go over some of our incredible auction items. Okay. So as you can see on the screen right now, sorry guys, I apologize. I'm losing my voice because I'm so excited. And I'm back with you. As you can see on the screen, you can name a room at the Kick for Life Hotel in Lesotho. There's an awesome Eli Manning MVP package available, beautiful art pieces available as well, some Soho Spa club passes, a golf day, lots and lots of options. $300 for a wine tasting event, stuff you won't want to miss. I'm going to let you scroll through that while I take another sip of water so that I don't lose my voice. And then we will go from. Okay, I'm back. So those are just a few of our great auction items that we have tonight. So let's start placing those bids, everyone. The silent auction will end tomorrow, Friday, November 6th at 8 p.m. Eastern time. So special thanks to all of those who donated those incredible items to this auction. As I mentioned, great stuff, as you can see. Lots and lots of stuff. Let's see, as we can mention, Kickstarter shirt. Let's see, what else is there? Name a room at the Lesotho Hotel. Soho spa packages, a photodynamic cosmetic therapy, a golf day. I mean, this is stuff you don't want to miss out on. These are great opportunities to bid. NYCFC signed jersey. As I mentioned, the Eli Manning package. Just to look through that. And if there's anything that you feel you'd like to donate or that you would like to bid on. So those are just a few of the great auction items that we have. Start placing those bids. The silent auction, as I mentioned, once again, to reiterate, Friday, November 6th at 8 p.m. Eastern. You have until then to bid on those items. Special thanks to all of those who donated the incredible items to this auction. So in addition to the auction, we have another really fun interactive element of the show this evening. Right now, you'll be getting a link in the chat to access the Kick for Life virtual photo booth. This is very exciting. So I told you guys, it's 2020, it's a weird year. The photo booth will be available through the night. And what we want you to do is use this link to take Kick for Life branded photos with your friends and your loved ones. Get creative, lean into this, guys. Lean into this virtual gala and into 2020. We wanna see you at home having fun representing Kick for Life tonight. And we're gonna highlight those at the end of the night. So stay tuned for that. Last but not least, before we begin, we wanna take a moment to recognize some of our incredible sponsors who have provided their ongoing support for Kick for Life and have helped shape this virtual event. So with that, I would like to say a special thank you to Wells Fargo for your continued support for Kick for Life, the fall fundraisers, with a special thank you to Andre Merkin from the NYC board. Also, very special thanks to those that have purchased virtual table sponsorship packages. As you can see your names on the screen, special thanks to Lawrence Lynch, Mike and Laurel Goodall, who have been long-term sponsors of Kick for Life, and a special shout out to Mike and Laura, as they've invited 100 guests tonight, and they would like to say thank you to those guests personally and to raise a toast. I'm gonna give you a chance to all raise your glasses right now and toast to Mike and Laura Goodall and all of those guests that have come together. And Mike and Laura, I just realized you guys can't see me on the screen. I actually have my champagne glass as well. It is currently empty. I'm waiting for my champagne to be sent to me as well. Okay, Peter Malloy, chairman of the USA board. Thank you so, so much for all of your donations. Alec Jiang of the NYC board, Mike and Natasha Tudor. You guys have been supporters for many years. We are so, so appreciative. Marlon Peterson of the NYC board. Thank you so, so much. And then John Growlick from the USA board. Once again, thank you so much for your support. Thank you guys for leaning into this, for also just doing these virtual tables. As I mentioned, 2020 is just such a different year. We're doing this virtually. You guys bought those virtual table packages and we're so, so appreciative. We love you guys, especially Mike and Laura. Sorry, my voice. I'm just so excited to be doing this tonight that I keep losing my voice. But Mike and Laura, I wanna make sure that I say thank you so much. You invited a lot of guests with you here tonight to learn about Kick for Life and to share in this program tonight. So thank you so, so, so very much. Cheers with my empty champagne flute to you guys as well. Hopefully it'll be filled up sooner than later. Okay. So we'd also like to thank our amazing board members and donors, many of whom are in attendance tonight. Thank you for all your support, but don't just take it from us. There's a few others who would like to say thank you as well.
Hello, my name is Lebeko Malus from the Kick for Life Academy. I would like to say a very huge thank you to Mike and Laura, Robin and India for supporting me through the Kick for Life program.
Hey, John Kalni. My name is Nkatlik Ahelo. Thank you for your support.
I would like to say a huge thank you to Mike and Natasha for supporting me through the Kick for Life program.
Hi, my name is Natalie Lizier. I'm the first ever female from the Lesotho to obtain a student athlete scholarship in the US. Thank you for supporting my journey.
I would like to say a huge thank you to Andre.
I would like to say a huge thank you to Anthony, Mike, Billy, and everyone at Bakerhurst for supporting me through the Kick for Life program.
I would like to say a huge thank you to Eric and Bill.
Thank you to Jake, Peter, Jasmine and Tilly for supporting me through the Kick for Life program.
Well, there you have it firsthand. It's so great to hear from the young people impacted by this program in Lesotho. Such beautiful young kids that you guys are helping to change their lives. It is absolutely incredible. Thank you to all of our sponsors. And now let's get back into our show. I am delighted to introduce a short film produced by Sports Illustrated about one of our guests tonight, Pookie, who is a true pioneer of women's soccer in Lesotho. She started off as a Kick for Life participant, and she is now working directly with the female players who are a part of the academy on their journey to obtain education in the United States. She is an absolute inspiration. Her story is incredible. Let's take a look at her incredible journey with Kick for Life.
There may not be a more unusual country in all of Africa. Entirely surrounded by South Africa, Lesotho stands as an island kingdom in the sky. But beyond the mountains and the stunning surroundings lies a stark reality. Lesotho has the world's second highest prevalence of HIV. With one in four people living with the disease, more than 160,000 children now orphaned, and a ravaged economy. Enter Kick for Life FC, the world's first soccer club exclusively dedicated to social change. The mission is to use football to transform the lives and long-term prospects of vulnerable young people in the country. This is Pookie. She found out that she was HIV positive when she visited Kick for Life. But rather than retreating into despair, she stayed and set up the women's football team.
This is your team?
Yeah.
When did you set it up and why did you set it up?
It was way back in 2010. When I came here, it was only four girls playing football, but without a team.
That's amazing.
Yes.
But now, seven members of the team play for the Lesotho national football team, right?
Yes, we're having seven players from Kick for Life who play for the national team.
Why was there no football team for women before you started it all?
Most people believe that soccer is only meant for men. It was like a taboo for a girl to play a football.
What happens to those players when they come to your team and they come onto the pitch for Kick for Life FC?
These girls are not only playing football, but they're also doing the community work. They come here to get life skills. They get all that the skills that they could ever need. So being a part of Kick for Life football team, it really changes their lives so much. Yes.
All right, so now I'm going to see your team on the pitch.
Yeah.
What a goal. Great goal. Hey, what was it like growing up out here?
I grew up with my brother, my uncles, and so I was the only girl among the boys. So every time when they were playing football, I would go and play with them.
What job did your mum do in the city?
She was working at a hotel. That's where she met my dad. Mm. So my mother never got married. And she had my brother with another guy whom I thought was also my dad. But when I was still in high school, my mother told me that my dad was not the person that I think he was. So I went to look for him and then I found him.
What was your age?
18. You know, when I first met my dad, he was happy to find me, but he was not treating me like his daughter.
No.
I felt like I was his girlfriend or something because of the way he was treating me. I was left alone in his house. His friend knew that I was alone. He just forced me and then he raped me. And then he shot me at the back. I was in hospital because I was in coma. Then I decided to get tested, and then the results were positive. Yeah.
Pookie has turned her pain into action. She is now working closely with the girls on the Kick for Life Academy program. The Academy adopts a long-term, holistic approach offering disadvantaged participants high school scholarships, soccer training, character development, and a range of support services including nutrition, tuition, and mentoring. The ultimate objective of the Academy is to develop young people on the program into high-performing academics capable of obtaining student-athlete scholarships at schools and colleges in the USA. The result is to genuinely and permanently remove these youths from the cycle of poverty, giving them the opportunity to achieve their potential. Along with Pookie, two of the current Academy scholars will be joining us this evening for a special interview. Sanate is Lesotho's first ever female student athlete to obtain a scholarship at a college in the US. Morikane is currently with the Academy attending high school in Lesotho. In 2020, she was the top scorer in the National Women's Super League at just 15 years old. Both of these girls are excelling both on and off the pitch with the support of Kick for Life. Tonight, at the first ever Kick for Life virtual gala, we are raising vital funds to enable more boys and girls to take part in the Kick for Life Academy, providing these young people with the opportunity to study in the US and transform their futures. Kick for Life are doing some amazing things here in Lesotho. Pookie's been able to start a soccer team, become a star in the top league, and she's now supporting others to achieve their dreams.
If I didn't chase football, I wouldn't be where I am right today. If I think I could have been dead, I wouldn't have tested. My HIV would turn into AIDS. But because I chased football, I chased my life as well.
Hi, I'm Amobi Okugo, professional soccer player and entrepreneur. Thank you for tuning in to tonight's Kick for Life virtual gala and supporting such a great cause. Give what you can and help Kick for Life change young lives forever.
Donate by texting GIVE followed by the dollar amount to 76278. For example, give $150.
Hello, Kick for Life. Miriam here. I'm so excited to be a part of this virtual gala. I know this year has been crazy, but we are here to raise money for the kids of Lesotho. I'm so happy to also be a part of the auction. I wonder who's gonna get the lucky, lucky happy birthday song that I'll be singing for whoever wins. Thank you so much for having me, and I'm excited to see all the content you guys have created for us today and to see what the kids of Kick for Life have been working on. Bye.
So you just got a chance to learn a little bit more about Pookie and her journey. And I told you just what an incredible story she had before. And now watching that video, I'm sure that you all feel the same way. One thing she mentioned that really stood out to me, she said, I chased football and I chased my life as well. And I think that that is just such an incredible story about how soccer can really, or football, can really play a role in social change. I was so excited and honored to interview her earlier on, and two of Kick for Life's inspiring leaders about their own perspectives, experiences, and hopes for gender equality, both on and off the field, as well as their individual journeys through the Kick for Life Academy. Before we get to that interview, I want to check back in with that thermometer that I showed you guys earlier in the night to just see how many more lives have been impacted by you all this evening. We're already at $27,000, and guys, we've only been doing this for a few minutes. We're only in the first portion of our show right now. I think we can go higher. I think we can get to that $70,000 mark tonight. I know it's difficult. I know it's weird. It's weird to be doing this from my living room, to be quite honest. But you know what? We get to be part of the change. We get to be part of the impact in the world. We can make the world a better place. We can do something good in 2020. So I am encouraging all of you to please get your phones out and text tonight. You can see in the chat right now, you can text give 25, give 50, give 100, give 250, give 500, give a dollar, give $500, give $5,000. Whatever you can do, please, please tonight feel motivated to do that. Please, if you're deciding whether or not grappling with whether or not you want to do it, just do it. You are making an immediate impact. You are changing lives, as you just saw from Pookie's story right there. Text that amount to 76278. And we're going to check back in with that thermometer in a little bit as well. But first, I want to introduce and welcome Pookie, Sanate, and Morikane. These were the three women that I had a chance to sit down with. I hope you enjoy listening to their story a little bit more.
We have three fantastic graduates from the Kick for Life program in Lesotho with me right now. These amazing young women are going to give us their own perspectives, experiences, and hopes for gender equality, both on and off the field, as well as demonstrate the work Kick for Life is doing on the field and in this field. So girls, welcome. I'm so happy and honored to be joined by you and to get a chance to just speak with you today. And Kuki, I want to start with you. You clearly have just such an incredible story. You're such a true pioneer of women's football in Lesotho. So I hope that we can just start by you just telling us the story of how you came to join Kick for Life and why it's so important to you.
Hi, everyone. I am Pookie. Like Michelle said, I work at Kick for Life as head of women football and also a program manager for Girls United. I first came to Kick for Life way back in 2010, and I was recruited by some of the friends that I knew. But however, me coming to Kick for Life, it was not only about football, but it was also about life skills. The reason why I like Kick for Life is because I have too many reasons, but I would like to share only one reason why I like being at Kick for Life. When I was still a little girl, I grew up with being raised by my mother, and I didn't know my dad. But however, when I was doing my final year at high school, I got introduced to my dad, who unfortunately, when I went to see him, I got raped and shot. And I couldn't be able to speak about the rape and the whole incident until I get to Kick for Life. One of our coaches came to me and then just wanted me to share my personal story with her, but she did not force me. I voluntarily wanted to share because of me hearing their story. I thought I was okay with everything until I came to Kick for Life, when I realized that I was not still healed. Because every time when a person was trying to tell me the story, I would be crying with them. Suppose it's a participant coming to me to tell me the story about abuse and everything, I would cry with them. Then I realized I'm still hurt inside. I need a healing. So I got counseling here at Kick for Life, and then I was healed, and I'm still healed, and I'm being able to deliver the life skills to other young people. So the reason why I like being here at Kick for Life is because I'm really passionate about football, and I'm really passionate about changing people's life, which is what I am, which are my roles, both my roles. So I enjoy it very much.
That's an absolutely incredible story, and thank you so much for sharing and being so honest. I'm so happy for you that you feel like you have the support that you needed to heal at Kick for Life, and that you two have come together. It seems like it's the perfect match for one another. So you're also working closely now with the Kick for Life Academy Scholars to support them to obtain student athlete scholarships in the United States. So how important is it to have a role model like Sanate as part of the program to just set aspirations for future student athletes for Kick for Life? I mean, I know you mentioned just trying to, you know, help other people and help advance not just the game, but have all of these women and men both learn life skills. So how important is it to have this opportunity as well?
It is very, very important, because all the time when I am delivering interventions to these young other girls, I always tell them about choosing the right role model. So for them, being in the program is very easy for anyone to say, I would like to be like Sanate, because they see, they have seen Sanate in Lesotho, they have seen Sanate growing, they have seen her pathways. And then if Sanate could actually be where she is today, then it's a great motivation to say, if Sanate was just somebody at Kick for Life playing football who happens to have this opportunity to study in US, I can also do that. Unlike having, I mean, some other, I don't know, American player who you want to be like, you don't even know the pathways that she took. You don't even know how you can relate to them. But with Sanate, it's very easy. With Maragani, with Queen, it's very easy, because people can actually relate and see, I have seen Sanate in Lesotho. I have seen her growing. And I can actually go back to her and say, Sanate, how did you get to where you are?
Yeah, and you sound so proud of them. And I want to start asking questions to Sanate and Maragani as well. But Pookie, first of all, also, I just want to say that you are such a role model as well. And I know you're talking about the other girls as well, but you are also just such a role model. So thank you so much for taking the time to just chat with me and share your story a little bit more. And as I transition now to Sanate, you are Lesotho's first ever female student athlete to attend college in the United States. So Firstly, I want to start with, well, first I want to just congratulate you because that's just incredible. I want to know what challenges maybe you faced early on being a girl playing football in Lesotho.
Like Pookie said, football is stigmatized into being a man-dominated sport in Lesotho. And growing up, I've been called names, discriminated, bullied for playing soccer, but that didn't demotivate me. Instead, it just motivated me to prove them wrong and show them that, you know what, girls can do better. And growing up, I've been playing with boys, and joining Kick for Life has actually provided me a platform to prove to them that, you know what, girls are as more deserving as boys deserve to play soccer or football.
Absolutely. Yeah. We probably have a similar problem now because
yes, I do.
Football is, yes, and with soccer and football, I know it's a thing. So lastly, Kick for Life has become the first top flight team in the world to commit to equal gender budget and pay. So what impact will that have in Lesotho, and just what does that mean to you overall?
It's a big opportunity for us, and it's inspiring to me as well, even though I've already gotten opportunities to go overseas in the US, but it just shows that all the hard work that we've been putting as all the Kick for Life team, from management to down to kids that come every Sunday to play soccer, it's motivation that we're doing something, and more especially for young girls growing up after me and seeing that we are going somewhere, and having this platform, it's saying, hey, we recognize you guys are playing soccer, we are playing football, and you deserve equal chances to do that.
Absolutely. Thank you so
much. And most importantly, I know it's providing education and mentoring and all the other career guidance, and having this opportunity is more motivation.
Now, I just want to transition to Morikane, last but not least. And as a Kick for Life Academy scholar, you're excelling both on and off the pitch. Last season, you were the top scorer in the Lesotho's Women's League at just 15 years old, which is just an awesome, incredible achievement. So congratulations to you, first of all, for that, because that's pretty cool. But I just want to know how you first got involved playing football, and then how did you end up at Kick for Life?
Thanks for being given this opportunity. Thank you very much for congratulating me, Michelle. I would say football is a family sport. Both my parents played football. First, my mom was a goalkeeper and my dad was a coach. But he played football before becoming a coach. So I would actually enjoy going to the training seasons that he had, watching the boys he trained playing. So I felt like, wow, I think I like this. I think I like this sport. Watching them playing will inspire me a lot. Watching them play will inspire me a lot. Coming in Kick for Life, my sister, I have two sisters. They play the Kick for Life Women's Super League. So they will tell me that today we're going to play a match. I'll be like, I want to watch you play. I want to be in the field too one day. So they'll be like, I'm playing for Kick for Life, so you could come and join the team. You should feel free. Yeah. That's when I started coming to Kick for Life. It's about 6 years ago. Yeah.
Wow. So it seems like football's in your blood. A lot of people have played.
Yeah.
It was only a matter of time, right? So I just want to ask, how has being a part of Kick for Life just helped your own life?
Being part of Kick for Life has helped me a lot. Helped me and my family, because they have paid my. I've got a scholarship. High school scholarship since I was in Form A, grade 8. And I'm receiving a great training sessions and character development classes, which are helping me to develop as a person. which are helping me to achieve my goal and work towards my potential.
That's awesome. You guys are, all three of you are just so inspirational. And I feel just so honored to even have the opportunity to speak with you guys today. I wish you all the best of luck. And thank you so much for taking the time to chat with me.
Well, guys, as you can see from that interview, the Academy changes lives. It provides these kids with an opportunity to receive an education and to learn life skills while playing the game that they love. One thing that stood out for me from that interview earlier on today was also just what Pookie said about other kids being able to see kids like Sanate that they grew up with going through these programs. They have real people that they can look up to who have gone through this before, who've been able to go through the Kick for Life program to play in the United States, to obtain these scholarships. And that is all because of you. That is because of the donations that you guys give to Kick for Life, that these three girls had an opportunity to reach their full potential in ways that they probably never imagined initially. These donations tonight and just in general, but especially tonight, are just so, so important and so urgent. We need these donations. We need more kids like Sanate, like Morikane, to get the opportunity to reach their full potential. So before we get into our special interview tonight with soccer star Giuseppe Rossi, let's kickstart that impact auction. We have some really impactful Kick for Life stories as we shared earlier tonight. You've seen how impactful Kick for Life can be for so many Lesotho youth. So let's do some more. I'm fired up to do some more. I was kind of trying to preserve my voice a little bit. It's probably going to go again because I'm going to get really excited again. So I'm just going to tell you that now. But with that, you should have received a text to make direct donations during the pledge drive. Hopefully you heard that while I was trying to gasp for air. But you can text by or donate by texting give in the amount that you'd like to donate to 76278. Okay. As you can see right now in the chat, you can give 25, you can give 50, give 100, give 250, give 500. Give whatever you feel inspired to do tonight, whatever you can do, but know that you are changing lives with your donation. What you do, wherever you are tuning in from, you are making a difference. So please act now. Please don't wait to act. Don't think about it. Just do it. Just text 762 in the amount that you'd like to give. Let's reach that $70,000 tonight, guys. We need this. Kick for Life needs this more than ever. This has been such a challenging year. We need that money. These kids need that opportunity as well. Let's be a part of something very special to change the lives of disadvantaged youth in Lesotho by holding this impact auction. So to give everyone some context of where your donations are going, because I'm gonna ask you for a lot of money tonight. As I mentioned, $70,000 is a lot of money. I wanna put some of that into context though, so that you see where that money is going, so that if you're grappling with whether or not you want to give that donation tonight, you know that the money that you're giving is being seen directly and immediately by these kids, okay? So you're gonna see $10,000 on the screen right now. As I mentioned previously, $10,000 enables us to put another young person in Lesotho through the program for an entire year. This lifts them out of poverty and supports them on a journey to graduate in the United States. We are looking for just one person tonight to start us off in the audience, one person who is willing to donate $10,000 for this program to put one person through Kick for Life. It is such an incredible opportunity for one of the Kick for Life participants. We just need one. You will make their dreams come true. You saw it by listening to Sanate, by listening to Morikane. Just text give $10,000 to 76278. Let's make a real difference, guys. This is your opportunity to do this. This is your opportunity to give that $10,000 to start us off. Such an incredible opportunity. One Kick for Life participant, you can make them their dreams come true. They can study in the United States. As a sponsor, you'll be able to track their progress and their support. They'll give you regular messages and updates to see how they're doing. This is just an option for you guys, but $10,000, I know that's a really big ask, but you would be giving so much for these kids. You would be giving them an opportunity to just have an endless potential, to reach their full potential. As a reminder, the Academy looks after every aspect of the participants' lives. That includes housing, nutrition, school, pastoral health, mental health, counseling, health, sports, private tutoring, so much more. all of that, that $10,000 really changes a life, okay? So let's just do this. Let's do it. Look at the impact your donations have had thus far. Look at Pookie, look at Sanate, look at Morikane. These are all of these people that you are directly impacting. I know you guys, I'm looking in the chat, everyone's saying this is so inspiring. I'm so inspired. Okay, let's do something about it. Let's let this inspiration continue. And you know what? It worked, my ranting just now. We have a $10,000 donation. Mike and Laura Goodall, you guys are just absolutely, cheers to you again. You're absolutely incredible. Thank you so much for your generous donation. You are changing a life. Everybody, please, thank you so much. I'm giving you a round of applause because if we were in person right now, you'd get a big round of applause. But thank you. This is absolutely amazing. I know, like I said, $10,000 is a lot of money. It's not for everyone. And that's, we totally understand that. We would like for you to just give anything that you can. And there's plenty of different options for you to do that. And we're going to go through all of that tonight. But thank you so much for that $10,000 donation. I'm absolutely floored. Is there anyone else that we can get to donate $10,000 tonight? If not, that's okay. You have time to donate and you can think about it a little bit if you want as well. But just know that you are instantly making a difference by donating. If you have the means to do it in 2020, which I know is a huge ask, please, please consider doing it because you are making a huge difference in the life of one very special child, okay? So while you're deciding whether or not you'd like to give $10,000, I'm gonna offer $5,000. So now you're gonna see $5,000 on your screen. We're trying to find two people in the audience that could give $5,000 each because that would put another child through the academy. If two different people could give $5,000, that's fine. We'll put the child through the academy with that way. And one of the great things about this academy is that there is a very clear pathway for each participant to transition from being severely disadvantaged when they first start the program to eventually receiving a college degree in the United States. These kids who are coming from just impoverished conditions and situations truly get a chance to transform their lives. They get a chance to go from this place where they just feel like there's no answer, no hope, to finding out their true potential because of your donations. All you have to do is text GIVE 5000 to 76278 to genuinely and permanently remove a child from the cycle of poverty. Guys, this is a complex process. It takes monumental effort, and I know we are asking for a lot tonight. The Kick for Life program, however, does just that. It's really incredible. All you have to do to be part of the process, together we can right now change another life like Sanate, like Morikane, like Pookie. I know you saw their stories. I know you were inspired by their stories. If you have the means to donate, please consider acting now. You can make an immediate impact if you have the means. I understand $5,000 is a lot of money, but if we can get someone, it would be great. And you know what? We just did. Peter Malloy, $5,000, has committed $5,000. Thank you so, so much for your support. Is there anyone else who wants to support another young person? We can get one more $5,000 donation. Peter, thank you for starting us off. Thank you guys for keeping the energy going. Look, I know this is tough. This is a different setting, but we got to keep the energy going. We have to remember the objective here. We need to raise the money for the youth in Lesotho so that Kick for Life can continue to do its incredible work. Can I get one more person to donate $5,000? Is there anyone that can donate? Remember, all you have to do is text the number on your screen. It's 76278, perfect timing, and text the amount that you'd like to give. And hopefully we can get another person there to donate $5,000. If we get one more person, that's $10,000, guys. That's another person through the program for an entire year, another life that you are changing. It's been so great already, guys, to see the support and love for the Kick for Life community. So please, let's keep this going. Anybody else that can donate $5,000, you can keep sending those donations, and it doesn't have to be right now. Take some time, talk about it with your family, and see if that's the right donation for you. While you're thinking about that, I'm going to ask for $2,500. If anyone can donate $2,500 to keep this thing going, that would be huge, okay? If we could get four people to donate $2,500, we can pull together another $10,000 of support. So another vulnerable young person in Lesotho can reach their potential, can go on this journey,
can see the United States. You know, we talked about in that video, just seeing, okay, so we're seeing that someone tried to text a very, very generous amount. So we will get working on that right now. Thank you so much. Do not give up because that's huge and we need that support. And we'll make sure to get that figured out for you as well. But back to the $2,500, like I was mentioning, guys, you saw that story. You saw Sanate talking about and Pookie talking about how these kids can see themselves through each other. They're seeing a path out of where their current situation is. And that is because of your support. They're able to dream. They're able to reach their potential. They're also able to learn life skills. Pookie talked about how she was going to chase, when she chased soccer, she chased her life. Okay, that is amazing. She was able to use soccer to help her, or football, to help her in her journey throughout her entire life and help shape the woman she is today. That is all through Kick for Life. She was given opportunities that she wouldn't have normally been given. And that is all because of you. So that is $2,500. If you could give $2,500 or over tonight, you'll receive video updates from the student that you support. You'll get those updates all year long, and you'll get a chance to just see firsthand, as you saw some of those videos earlier tonight, just all of the work that you're doing and the impact and the difference that you get to make. So if you can do it, I know $2,500 is a lot of money, but if you can do it, we would greatly, greatly appreciate that tonight, okay? Everyone who gives $2,500 or over tonight, as I mentioned, you'll get a video update throughout the year that will show you the student that you're supporting, that will track their progress. So you'll get a chance to see firsthand just where your money is going. The social return of investment is very, very high at the Academy. The scholarships that are obtained in the US are worth hundreds of thousands of dollars for these students. So the benefit of your support and helping to prepare these kids for that opportunity is so clear to see, okay? As I was talking about earlier, not only just watching that video with Pookie talking about how the kids can see themselves in children like Sanate and Morikane, they're also motivated to come back and give back into their own communities. They become role models. You saw Pookie was in the program herself. Now she's coaching in the program. She's teaching these young kids. She's being a role model for these young kids. These are the next generation of change in our world. These are the next generations of leaders in our world. We need to support them. We need to give them the resources that they need to be successful. Okay, guys? So $2,500, if you can do it, please do it, 76278. If not, I would love for you guys, wow, thank you so much. Thank you so much. A $5,000 donation from Eileen and Bill Schwitter. We're hoping that it went through. We'll reach out to you, hopefully that it did go through, but thank you so much, because if that's the case, then we had another student that we can put through. So that was another $10,000 between you and Peter. Thank you, thank you, thank you so, so much. Guys, we're literally just getting started with this though. So please do not think that this is enough. We need to keep donating. Please give $2,500 if you can give it. I know it's a lot. How about 1,000? If we can get 10 people in our audience to donate $1,000, we can collectively raise another $10,000, right? We're doing a lot of math here tonight. If 10 people can give $1,000, we will collect $10,000 and we can put another student through the Academy. If that's not the case, that's all right. The $1,000 will provide accommodation for each scholar on the program in a safe and supportive environment. These kids will not have to worry about where they're staying. They won't have to worry about if there's proper chaperoning. They won't have to feel like they're at risk, like their safety is in jeopardy. The $1,000 will provide accommodation for each scholar on the program so that they have a place that they know they can go that is theirs, that is their home. That is huge. These are things that we take for granted. We have our homes. We're living in them, our homes right now. We're joining each other from our homes. Imagine going through a program and not knowing if you were going to have a place to stay, wanting to go through this program, wanting to experience these things, but knowing that you don't have the funds to do so. And so feeling like you don't have the opportunity to do so. If you can give $1,000, I know it's a big ask, but if you can give it, please consider donating tonight. Please consider doing it tonight. Right now, 76278, you hold the keys to the future here. You can make a direct impact by donating. Don't overthink it. If you have the money, please consider giving it to Kick for Life tonight, okay? Every dollar raised is crucial at this stage and will make a significant difference in the lives of young people in the Kick for Life program.
Just a reminder, in case I haven't reiterated it enough, you are completely transforming a life with your donations tonight. Each scholar is on a journey from being severely disadvantaged to all the way to obtaining a college degree in the United States, a college degree that can help them to transform their lives, that can open doors, that can help them reach their full potential. You can help do that with them or for them. So please consider doing that. Text GIVE1000 to 76278. Please consider donating. Let's get these donations in. To all of you who have already, thank you so much. You guys have really started to kickstart us and really start this going, but we need more donations. We need more here. So if anyone can consider donating $500, let me tell you what $500 will cover, okay? Because this is pretty crazy. $500 will cover high school fees of each Academy scholar. All right, 2020, we're all at home. We're all sitting here. A lot of our kids are in remote learning. They're taking classes from home. High school is not free in Lesotho. Many kids have had to drop out of school because of that. When we're sitting here complaining about the fact that we're doing remote learning, imagine not even having the opportunity to do remote learning because you don't have the money to go to school. There is a 71% dropout rate from primary school going into high school in Lesotho because families are unable to afford the fees. The Academy takes a huge financial pressure away. I can't emphasize that enough, a huge financial pressure away from these scholars. Originally, they would be wondering whether or not their families could afford for them to go to school. If they could afford the school fees, would they be able to go back year after year? You can help change that for another Academy student. I'm asking for $500. $500 pays for their high school fees. You are giving them the keys to receive an education. You are helping them reach their full potential and get their goals and reach their own goals. $500. I know it's a lot of money, but if you can do it, please consider donating $500 and knowing that you are making a direct impact on these kids' lives. You are changing the lives of the youth in Lesotho. You're giving them an opportunity to grow into the human beings, into the adults that they want to become. And then in turn, hopefully giving back to their own communities and setting an example in their own communities and being role models in their own communities. You can help change their lives, okay? That's $500. I understand it's a lot of money, but if you can do it, guys, we would love to have you. That's 76278. Please give $500, 76278. And if you can't give $500, I understand it. It's not for everyone. So that's why $250 is an option as well, okay? $250 will contribute towards the nutritional support for each scholar. More than half of all adolescents in Lesotho don't have access to a balanced diet, causing physical and emotional or an educational developmental issues. The Academy program supports each participant to have proper nutritional intake. So how many times do we just go to the grocery store and not even think about it? We just get groceries. We know that we need our groceries. In our groceries, we have our fruits, our vegetables, you know, some meat, some poultry, whatever it is that we want to get from the grocery store. For $250, we can make sure that kids in Lesotho have the nutritional support that they need to help grow into healthy adults. We know that proper nutrition affects not just our physical being, it also affects our mental being. For $250, we can help give these kids the opportunity to get the nutritional support that they need. Each scholar, I'm getting texts from my inside sources who are telling me that we have a lot of different donations coming through. We'll get a little bit more detail in a few minutes so I can give you guys some shout outs, but thank you so much for donating. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to listen to my whole spiel. I know it's different. There's no music to pump us up and to distract us and to keep us going, but hopefully that just motivates us even more to donate, to get to that $70,000 tonight, to know that we are here for a cause. And that reason is very, very, very important. Okay. So if you can't do $250, can you consider giving $100 tonight? $100 tonight would go very, very far. Okay. $100 provides a full soccer training kit and a tracksuit for the scholar. All you have to do is text GIVE100 to 76278. You will be able to give with that $100. Let me just tell you what that gives. That full soccer training kit and tracksuit. You are basically kitting out a child with their official gear so that if any of you guys have kids, you know how cool it feels for your kids to have their uniforms, to wear their soccer uniforms. They love their jerseys. I know I did growing up as well. I really loved wearing my jersey with my name on the back, and it made me feel so proud. That's a big deal. $100 will provide that full training kit so that when these kids walk around, they walk around with pride. They know they're a part of a team. They know that they're part of something bigger than themselves. The track suit as well, for when they go to their classes, they can wear the official track suit. They can feel like they're part of the team. It just gives them something to be proud of, something that's theirs, that they have earned, that they've worked for by being part of that team. You can provide that for them. It's just $100. I know a lot of you guys said you were joining from all over the world, but I know in New York City, $100 goes like that. I mean, I feel like I walk out my door and I've spent $100. I don't even know how it happens. How about we actually try to consciously put that $100 towards something that will actually make a difference in this world? Help make someone feel better. You can do that. You can make these kids feel better. It's just $100 and it would make a huge difference in their lives. So I encourage you to donate $200, $500, $1,000, $5,000. Anything you can donate tonight is great. I know 2020 is such a challenging year. I know we're all at home. If you're in the UK, I think you just got back put under lockdown. This is very challenging. We've never dealt with this before, but that makes it even more important to donate. I know we're all sitting at home, like I was just mentioning, if you're back in lockdown, maybe you feel like, God, I really want to do something. I want to help. I want to do more in the world, in the community, and I can't. This is the perfect way to do it. The money that you are donating tonight will go directly to Kick for Life. You are directly making an impact automatically, just like that. I know a lot of us feel helpless right now. I know we feel like we don't really know what's going on in the world. It's very divisive right now. Let's do something good in 2020 together. Let's come out of this with a win, okay? Let's make a difference for the future generations so that they can have the opportunity to make this world a better place. You're doing that tonight by your donations. I just cannot emphasize that enough. So if $100 isn't right tonight, if you can't commit to a big amount tonight, no problem, okay? We totally understand. Is there an option for you to try to donate monthly, to donate $75, $50, $25, $15, any amount that you can per month? In order to do that, all you have to do is visit k4lvirtualgala.givesmart.com and choose monthly and the amount that you'd like to contribute in the donation menu. If you look over in the chat right now, exactly what I just said is there as well, so that you guys can see it spelled out for you. It's k4lvirtualgala.givesmart.com. Choose monthly and the amount that you'd like to contribute in the donation menu. The link is there in the chat. A monthly donation, guys, it'll really help. The money goes further to support young people throughout the year. The money maybe isn't spent on all one thing at once. You can spend that money incrementally throughout the year and help people in the best way you can. Look, there's no right or wrong way to give. However you want to give is up to you. And we are so greatly appreciative of however you decide to do that. Whether you decide to give $5 a month, a coffee at Starbucks is $5. Maybe think about that Starbucks coffee and instead put that $5 towards helping young people in Lesotho. Help them have the opportunity that you have had to have a life where you're in a place where you can donate, where you can make a difference, where you can give back. Because I guarantee you that they will want to do the same and they will not forget the people that helped them along the way. And those people are you. So I want to thank you all for all of your donations, for listening to my spiel this whole time. And I want to get back to the show. But before we do that, I'm going to check in on the thermometer. Let's see how much of an impact we've been making so far. Let's see how close we are to our goal. And let's use that as a real conscience checker to see if we can get even closer if we're not there yet. So if we could just pull up the thermometer on the screen, I would love to see how far we are towards our goal. Holy cow. That's the first time I'm seeing that. And that is amazing. $69,341. That is absolutely amazing. Thank you. Thank you so much. That I'm like at a loss for words right now. That's huge. Thank you so much for those donations. Thank you for believing in Kick for Life and for seeing the impact that Kick for Life is making in this world, in Lesotho. These kids are coming into the United States. They're bringing their experience into the United States. They're making the United States a better place. These children are the gems of the world, and they are such great, appreciative kids, and you are giving them an opportunity to just reach their full potential. So thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Do not stop there, okay? $70,000, we're close. We got to hit $70,000, by the way, tonight. We're so close. Can someone just give me $500? Can someone give me maybe $1,000 so we can get over the hump and just get to 70,000? Because if we get there, I'm telling you guys, that is absolutely amazing. We are going to have to, I mean, I have no champagne in this glass still, but well, I'll go buy some so that we can cheers, because that is just absolutely incredible. Can we get to that $70,000 mark tonight before this show ends? I am imploring you, someone, yes, get us over the line, guys. Come on, text give $500 to 76278. Someone do it. Come on, we are so close. And when we do it, I'm going to go back to that thermometer and we are going to celebrate, because that is absolutely amazing. What an incredible accomplishment tonight. What an incredible achievement. This program has only been going on for an hour, and we have raised almost $70,000 to make a difference in Lesotho for Kick for Life. I am just so overjoyed by all of your support. Thank you so, so very much. I'm going to give us a few minutes to get that rest of that money in and to keep donating. Don't feel like we have to stop at 70,000. Let's see how far we can go. I mean, this is amazing. I love how generous you guys are all feeling tonight. This is just absolutely incredible. It has been such a great show so far. So while we wait for that number to keep going up, we're going to welcome in international soccer star Giuseppe Rossi. He really needs no introduction. He's had an incredible career playing in La Liga. He's played in the English Premier League with Manchester United. He's now in Major League Soccer playing for Real Salt Lake. Rossi has also been a longtime supporter and Kick for Life ambassador since 2012. So he has seen this program evolve. He has seen the lives that it has impacted and changed. Check out this interview with him. I think you'll really enjoy it. Giuseppe, you've represented and captained your country. You've played in three of Europe's top leagues, and you've been a top scorer at the Olympics. All things considered, what would you say is your greatest career achievement to date?
I mean, there's a lot of achievements during this 17 years. It's been already 17 years. Can't believe it. I still remember the first day as if it was yesterday. You know, just being able to play at this high level, being able to represent my country and the great clubs that I have played for. It's definitely a dream come true.
How would you say that you've evolved? You know, you mentioned it's been so many years, but it feels just like yesterday. How have you evolved as a player and then as a person throughout this career so far?
Yeah, you learn a lot during the many years that you play. You know, you start off young and always wanting to prove yourself. And then you step into a phase where you have proved yourself, and how can we get better to be one of the best? And then you reach this phase. You know, I'm 33 right now, and I'm towards the end of my career, and it all comes all together, right? You have all those thoughts of saying, oh, I wish I was that young, where, you know, I'm running around like crazy and you know, continuing to prove myself. And then you have the willingness to always be the best, So this is the phase that I'm in right now. It's a tough phase just because I know that it's towards the end of my career. I don't want it to end. I definitely don't want it to end, but I'm trying to train my mind. I'm trying to train my mind and, you know, get it ready for these next few years, these last
years. You have another beautiful, I guess, step in your life on the horizon, though. You're expecting a little baby girl. So congratulations. I mean, that must be so exciting for you.
Yes, yes, yes. That's something new. That's something that we've been waiting for a long time. It's finally here. And we can't wait till she's among us.
Well, congratulations again on that. I want to go back to the beginning of your career, though. You had the opportunity to play for the U.S. men's national team when you were younger, but you decided to go with Italy. And I know you've probably gotten this question a lot over your career, or throughout your career, I guess. But why Italy, and why was that the right decision for you and your family at the time?
Because it's all I knew. The Italian national team is what I watched when I was a young kid. I used to watch the Serie A every single Sunday. Me and my father, we would wake up at 9 o'clock and just watch our games every Sunday. So, you know, having that Italian culture and just watching Italian soccer was something that was, you know, part of my upbringing. And when I had the opportunity, I really didn't think twice.
And what was that like for you? I mean, you mentioned your dad and having that special relationship, watching games together. For you then to be on the pitch, what was that like for you guys?
Oh, it was a dream come true. I mean, it's like it's the best thing that could happen to a player when you're able to represent your country, play an important role in representing your country during those years. And, you know, I was blessed enough, to be in that position and knowing that it's something that your family was really proud of and they cherish so much just made it even more special.
Absolutely. Over the years, you faced a number of injury setbacks, but you always managed to come back stronger. What life skills did you need to stay motivated throughout that time? And, you know, you're talking to me now about even transitioning your mind as you progress through your career. You're saying is maybe the back half of your career. Tell me about just your mindset throughout these times, just to overcome each challenge that you faced.
Yeah, you learn a lot about yourself. You learn a lot about yourself. These are things that are not in your script. They're not. It's not something that you put in your dreams of being a soccer player, right? So you have these injuries, and it's how am I going to deal with it now? How am I going to react towards all these negative things that come with injuries? And yeah, I mean, I learned a lot. I learned that that I don't give up. I learned that that it's very important to have a strong backbone, which is your family, and I had them support me throughout these long injuries. And the dream never died. It was always in my head that I want to come back stronger, better. And that's what kept everything alive. That's what kept everything, going, me pushing myself every single time that I had to in order to get past these bad moments in my career. And it makes you a better person, even outside of soccer.
Would you say too that there are characteristics and things that you learned about yourself that maybe you didn't even know you had inside yourself, the resilience that you had? You mentioned that drive to just keep going. Sometimes when we're faced with like real adversity is when we learn things about ourselves and it ends up bringing out some of the best sides of ourselves.
Yeah, I mean, you said it right. You learn a lot about things that you thought that you never had. There's people that are capable of just letting go when there's certain obstacles in life. And I learned to always persevere. I always learned to fight. I always learned to, think about how much we put into this dream. Not just me, but my family. And, not letting them down. Mm-hmm. Continuing to make them proud, even though I'm not on the field scoring goals and playing a game. Just making them proud. And showing them that they raised a good kid. They raised a kid that doesn't give up, and that he's always going to stick to what he says and to what he wants to, accomplish in life. And I'm still here today fighting. I'm still here today playing, enjoying myself as much as I can. Mm-hmm. And it's been 17 great years, a lot of ups, a few downs, but we made we pulled through it, and we're all happy with smiles, and you know, we're having a lot of great things happening to us on the field and off the field.
Absolutely. Speaking of perseverance, you've seen the work of Kick for Life progress over the years, changing lives in Lesotho. So what is it about soccer that makes it such an effective tool for social development?
Soccer brings everybody together. It's a sport that everybody in the world loves, that everybody in the world follows. And they're very curious about the sport, right? So you have a lot of people from all over the world that that want to play it, that want to, you know, be like their hero that they see on Sundays. It's broadcasted all over the world, soccer, so everybody watches it. And that, you know, curiosity of trying to learn the game, of trying to play the game, brings many, many people together. And you know, Kick for Life is a great example of this, you know, using the sport to bring people together, to bring a lot of awareness, which they are, with the kids in Lesotho. And I'm very, very proud to be part of this, to be part of this charity.
How have you seen just the positive effect that this game can have on so many people? I mean, you kind of mentioned it earlier, you played all over the world. You saw it firsthand in your own career, but then also with programs like Kick for Life, just how soccer has this ability to bring people together. Just can you elaborate a little bit more on that for me?
Yeah, I traveled the world and I played everywhere. And I've seen such great passion that all these fans have, if it's in Africa, if it's in Asia. I remember my first trips when I was 17 years old, I was playing for Manchester United and we went to South Africa. And the love that they have for this game was crazy. Yes, I knew that soccer was very popular in Europe, growing in America, but I never really experienced that love for the game that they had in Africa, in Asia. And it's just amazing what a soccer ball and a rectangular field does to people. It just brings so much passion. It just brings everybody together. And
absolutely,
it's just blessed, you know, to be able to be part of the sport, playing at such a high level, helping these young kids become closer to the sport, learning the game, and then such great benefits that it has while you're in the game.
Yes. Some of those incredible benefits are these scholarship athletes that get a chance to come and play in the United States. You're now playing in MLS. How do you see the future of soccer just shaping up in the United States? And what do you think this means for Kick for Life scholars who maybe are studying and playing soccer here?
I mean, I think it's great to combine both things, the athletic and the academic part of the scholarship. Yes, it's very, it's great playing, but you know, it's very important never to forget about the academics. And this is what Kick for Life is trying to teach these young kids. And it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. I come from a family where my parents, they're teachers, and they've always, they always said that, you know, school is very important, studying is very important. I've studied, I finished my school. They're very happy. And I'm happy that Kick for Life is doing this also. You know, regarding the sport in America, it's growing a lot. It's getting to where it should be. It still takes, it's still going to take a few years to reach certain levels. But, you know, with these small increments of improvement that we're seeing with the World Cup coming to the USA, it's just going to bring more awareness and more passion to these young kids.
Absolutely. Giuseppe, thank you so much for taking the time. We really appreciate just getting a chance to catch up with you and see how you've been doing.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Hey, guys. I'm Corey Proctor, former Dallas Cowboy and current owner of Pro Capital Wealth Management. I'm here to say thanks so much for joining us for the Kick for Life virtual gala and to ask you to give what you can. We got to change some young people's lives and impact them in a huge way. So give what you can, do what you can, and let's do something good. Thank you.
Donate by texting GIFT followed by dollar amount to 76278. For example, give $250.
Wow. Well, that was an incredible interview with Giuseppe. Thank you so much for just taking the time, Giuseppe, for using your platform the way that you have over the years and the way that your career has flourished. We are amazed by it. It's been great to watch you as an athlete. And when you do eventually transition into being a father and your next phase in life, we'll be there to cheer you on as well. Thank you for being such a big supporter of Kick for Life over the years. Everything that you guys do really does make a difference. And what a great way to wrap up our show this evening. So I was holding off on this because I am very, very anxiously awaiting to see how well we've done, but let's check back in on that thermometer and get a sense of where we stand with our fundraising. I have not seen it since we saw it last. Oh guys, we're so close. We got to get to 70,000. We got to get to 70,000 before we get off this call. We have to do it. Can we collectively donate $100 each? Can I get five people to donate $100 for this? We have to. We can't end this call without getting to the $70,000. We are so, so close. Please, can one person give 250? Can one person give 100? Can one person give 25? Anything you can give. We have someone who's trying. Very good. The number is 76278. You have to text give 25, give 50, give 100, give 250, give 500, give any amount that you can to 76278. We got it. We got it. We're over the $70,000 mark. Guys, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so, so much. You did this. You did this tonight. This is honestly, the first good thing it feels like to come out of 2020. Thank you so very much for your support tonight. $70,000. Over $70,000, I might add, and it's climbing. I mean, just so, so, so incredible. Thank you so much for this. Thank you, guys. Thank you, everyone, for your support. This is absolutely, absolutely amazing. To keep giving, make sure you text 76278 and give with the amount that you'd like to give, okay? We are over our goal for the night, but we are not over our goal in general. We need to keep giving. The objective remains the same. Let's put as many kids as we can through the Kick for Life program in Lesotho. Let's give them the tools to succeed. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so, so very much. With that, I'm gonna take a break, take a breath, because I can tell I'm about to lose my voice again. With that, we're gonna announce our prize draw winners for the night. Our prizes tonight are 11 very special edition Kick for Life FC jerseys from this season. You can't buy these. You can't get them in any stores. They are special edition jerseys. And the winners for that are as followed. You'll see your names on the screen. Jay Moody, Patricia Berry, Alyssa Fennenbach, John Growlnick, Will Griffith, Jack Wise, Surrenda Kellendy, Phil Kolb, William Stredwick, Mika Taiji, and Alex Stainburn. I apologize if I mispronounced any of your names. I promise that my intentions were pure here. Congrats to all of you. Someone from Kick for Life will reach out to you with how to claim your jerseys. And guys, with that, it's the official end of our show tonight, but that does not mean you stop donating. That just means that I'm not going to be bothering you to donate anymore. But thank you. Thank you so, so very much. You guys have been an absolutely amazing audience tonight. I cannot thank you enough for your dedication to this cause, for giving your evening to us tonight, for spending it together. It does not stop here, though. As I mentioned, it keeps going. Follow Kick for Life on social media to stay up to date on all of the latest programming, updates, news, and future event information. Please support Kick for Life by continuing to make donations. And of course, by staying up to date with our participants, our academy, and our programs. You can do that by visiting us at kickforlife.org. Also, I mentioned that virtual photo booth early on. So we're shortly going to feature those photos as well that you guys have been taking. I hope you've leaned into those just as much as you've leaned into this last hour of programming. We would not be where we are today without you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for the difference that you have made tonight and the difference that I know you will continue to make going forward. Also, don't forget that the silent auction ends tomorrow, Friday, November 6th at 8 p.m. Keep bidding on that. Make sure you go back and look at those items again because I couldn't really speak at that time. So I didn't feel like I really gave you a good description of all of the incredible items that we have up for auction. Please go make bids on them. There is some really, really, really great stuff in there. So that's it. What a night. Thank you guys so much for your support. Please help us continue to reach our goals and keep the donations coming in and enjoy the awesome photo booth that you guys are going to now see and the tunes from DJ Hanza. Thanks so much for letting me be part of your night tonight.
Not going to be really true, but when somebody makes you say it, okay.